Allowed us to discover the very things that the rabbis knew thousands of years ago.
It's a very fascinating study.
All right, but let me just give you one example to give you a flavor of this. This is Genesis chapter 1 in Hebrew. I want to remind you that Hebrew goes from right to left. Also, the Torah in Hebrew is spelled with four letters. A tau, which is roughly equivalent to our T, an O, a hey, four letters. If you go to the first how in the book of Genesis, and that's the last letter of the Hebrew alphabet, it happens, and you count 49 letters, you come to Vav. You count 49 more letters
to a Resh,
which is sort of like our R, and you count four letters, you come to a Hey. So that is four letters spelled Torah. Now I need to remind you that all languages flow towards Jerusalem. All nations east of Jerusalem go from right to left. All nations west of Jerusalem go from left to right. All languages flow towards Jerusalem. I don't know what you're going to do with that piece of information, but I think it's interesting. Now, you can follow this. You say, now, why 49? Was it square?
Fine.
That's not too surprising, but just a coincidence, of course. Now, you could argue, well, that's just an accident. Frequency of letters and so forth. It's kind of rare, but interesting.
What happens is when you go to the book of Exodus,
first how... Count 49 letters, you get a Vav. 49 letters, you get a Resh. 49 letters, and you get a Hey. Same thing happens.
What's the probability of that?
Whatever the first probability is, it's that squared. Okay? So it's very unlikely. This is Exodus. You go to Leviticus, and it doesn't happen. And when it doesn't, you almost feel a sigh of relief.
Numbers.
The same thing happens in backwards. Hey, the first Resh, the first Vav, the first Tau. You get Taurus backwards. Now that's what we have, nothing else. I don't know how they found this out. They must have had time on it. They didn't have computers. You know, this was. Go to Deuteronomy, have it, essentially the same equivalent thing happens. And now you're puzzled because you've got it forward, forward, backward, backward. Can't resist going back to Leviticus and looking at Leviticus more closely. We have 49 and 7 squared letter sequences. Torah, forward in Genesis, Exodus, backwards in Numbers and Deuteronomy. Leviticus, you discover that every seventh letter spells the unpronounceable name of God, often rendered Jehovah or Yahweh, expressed Adonai among the Hebrews. They won't pronounce that name. They'll use Lord, the word Lord instead.
Well, now we stand back from all of this. We have the name of God, and we suddenly realize that the Torah always points to the name of Jehovah.
Now, what's the chance of that happening by accident?
By the way, if you've tried to contrive
and still maintain logic in the text, that's a challenge. This is a very non-trivial thing to design if you set out to design it that way. So many of us tend to regard these in general as fingerprints of the Holy Spirit.